Everyone, welcome to another video by PythonPool. In this video, we're gonna see strand sort algorithm. Now the question arises, what is strand sort and how does it works? So strand sort is a recursive sorting algorithm that sorts item of a list into increasing order. What it does is it takes the first position, zeroth position of the list, compare according to that digit present at the zeroth position, it compares the list. And the elements, all the elements greater than that position. Let's see in this example, what it did, it take 4. All the elements greater than 4 would be popped out from the list. And it would be appended to the another list, let's say list B, in the sorted order. Now, coming back to the list A, which was our original list, it takes the element which is now present at the zeroth position. Again, it's does the same thing, compares that number with the whole list and find all the digits which are greater than this, pop out from the list A, append to the list B. In this case, everything popped out from the list A and appended to the list B in the sorted order gives the list B as the sorted list. So now in Python, let's see how we define program for the strand sort. First of all, I'm going to code one file, name it as test.py, and once my file is ready, I'm going to write my function itself. My function name is strand sort, and what it would take a list. Now after taking a list, remember we talked about the another list which could be the sorted list afterwards. I'll name that list as out. So that is our list. And it would make one more function, name it as strand, and this strand would does the algorithm for it. So what it does is strand would does the algorithm, and it would generate one more function which will merge the list. So once we took 4, we saw that 5 was only 5 was greater than 4. So 4 and 5 were popped out from the list A and appended to the list B. Now we took 2. 2 only 3 was greater than 2, so 2 and 3 were popped out from list A, but when appending to the list B, it is being merged. So for that merging, we'll be doing by another function. I'll define that function. So first of all, we call this strand function for comparing algorithm. And once we called this function, once we got the number, once we popped out that number of elements from the list A, while my list is not empty, I need to run this algorithm. Get out, we'll call the merge list function. Once the elements is being popped out, I need to merge the list. Out and strand L once again. These two lists I need to merge, and after all it is done, I need to return this out list. Okay, now I'm going to define this strand function which would do the original logic for us. So def strand, strand, and it would take a list. Okay, after taking the list, what it would do to take two variables, I and S. I would be the position, that is 0, and S would be the element at that position. So that is L would pop the element placed at the zeroth position. Okay, so this would be the S. Now I'll run the loop while my I is less than. After popping out the first position, I need to compare that element present at the first position with the whole list and all the elements greater than that element, that number, I need to pop out all of them. So how I do that, I run the loop, and if my li is greater than s, and s what, s of minus 1. Okay, if my this is greater than that element, if the element present in the list is greater than the first element, what I need to do, I need to append them into s, and I need to pop them from L, pop the ith element from the L and append that to the S. Okay, And if it is not the condition, then what I need to do else, my I should be increasing, should keep increasing. Okay. So this would be my condition. And after all it is done, what I need to do, I need to return this S, because that is what our sorted list is. So I need to return the S. Okay. So return S. I'm done with strand 2. Now I'm going to define this merging function, merging list. Merge list function I'm going to define, because we have two lists. Now we need to merge those two lists. So above this one, I'm going to define this merge list function, def merge list, and it would take two lists, because while calling this function, we are giving two lists. So I'll give A and B as the two lists. Okay. And after taking that, it would define one array that is initially empty. This list is initially empty. And while my A and B is not empty, so both should be filled. My A and B, nothing would be empty. So both should be filled. And if my A0, the element present at the 0th position, is less than element present at the B0 position. So I need to compare the list. If my A list is have lesser element than the B list, A list would be appended first and B list would be appended last. But if the condition is not similar, if the condition is different, if the condition is opposite, what I need to do? I need to append first B list and then append the A list. So if this is the case, if my A list is less than the B list, what I need to do? Out, we are appending in the out. So out dot append, and I need to append whatever there is present in the A list. So whatever is present in the A list, I need to append that one. And if it is not the condition, I need to append B. So append B dot pop 0. This would be the condition. And after every looping, after every condition, I am going to increase my out list with A and B two. B. Okay. And after all it is done, my list is being sorted. I am going to return that list. Now I am going to define my list. I am done with all the logics and the functions. I am going to define my list here. My list is fixed, as I am going to implement that one. My list is 4, 2, 5, 1 and 3. This is my list. I'm going to call this strand sort function. After calling this, I'm going to pass this L1 list, and whatever it returns, I'm going to append that, store that in a rest variable. And after that, I need to print this rest variable. Once I hit save, I go back to my terminal and I'm gonna run. You could see we got our sorted list. So now let's see in Python how we implemented this program. Let's see that. Implementation of strand sort. This was our list initially. We got S equals to 4 because 4 was present at the initial position. So in other case, 4 and 5 element and the element greater than that element are popped out from the list and are appended to 4 and 5. This 4 and 5 were popped out and were appended to another list, that is out. Now let's say this is list L1. So till now we are running the strand function. We ran the strand sort function initially. Now we are running the strand function. Once again we got this list 2, 1, 3. Now 2 would be present in the S. Once again we popped out 2 and 3. Okay, and appended it into the next list. Let's say this list is L2. Now we will be calling our merge list function. Merge list function, what it will do, it will merge this L1 and L2 list in the sorted manner, and this 2, 3, 4, 5 list would be formed. Now I have S equals to 1, but there is none other element present in the list, so I need to compare this. So my strand sort function will not run. Directly my merge sort function will run, merge list function will run, and I am going to get my sorted list. So this is the implementation of our program today. So that's it from this video. Hope you're having a great day ahead. Thank you.